Jesus. We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne, and Callaway have relaunched their Callaway-Chrome-Soft golf balls for 2020. So we've done quite a bit of testing with the Chrome-Soft, the standard ball, but now we're back to put the Chrome-Soft-X, which is played by Phil Mickelson, Francesco Molinari, and of course Xander Schauffele, up against Titleist Pro V1 and Titleist Pro V1x. And we're going to show you how they compare with a driver, an iron, and a wedge. Whilst Neil's out testing, let me tell you a bit about what you need to know about this new Callaway Chrome Soft X golf ball, because it's very different compared to previous versions. Here's something I shot earlier. What do you need to know about the Callaway Chrome Soft X? Well, it's absolutely no secret at all that Callaway were caught out last year in 2019 when a number of their golf balls were found out in the marketplace with the core off center, which obviously affects performance. Callaway basically come back and they've said, well, we've spent $50 million updating our golf ball plant, so this will never happen again. And they've invested in new machinery, new methods, and also new x-ray machines. So every single golf ball that now leaves the plant is now x-rayed across three different axes, which basically means or ensures that every single core is right in the center of the golf ball. And also each layer that's on the outside of that core is also a regular thickness the whole way around. So there's no off-center cores anymore. It's no surprise then that Callaway have relaunched the Chrome Soft for 2020. And they feel that they've got a real opportunity to target elite players as this new ball is very different compared to previous models. What Callaway have done is they've made sure that there's a much bigger choice, there's a bigger gap between the two balls. So the standard ball is aimed at 100 mile an hour swing speeds and below, whereas the X ball is aimed at 105 mile an hour swing speeds and above. And if your swing speed falls in the middle of those two, you need to really choose whether you want the softer feel of the standard ball or the extra driver performance of the X ball. So what's actually changed about the Chrome Soft X over previous models? Well, there's a brand new core. It's 117% bigger, so a very different construction method. It's a little bit firmer compared to previous models, and the outer core is a little bit softer. And what Callaway are basically saying is that means that they don't need graphene in the X ball, but it's still being used in the standard ball. Also, the cover on both balls is 22% thinner, which really helps the cover bite into the grooves on wedges and irons, so you're maximizing spin as well. And also, there's a different aerodynamics package, so the pattern on the X ball is a little bit different compared to what you'll find on the standard ball, all aimed at optimizing each ball for its intended target golfer. What does that mean in terms of performance? Well, what Callaway is saying is that the new X ball is really aimed at launching for a tour window, so a little bit lower than what you'd get with the standard ball. And what Callaway is basically saying is that compared to the previous model, you can add another 7 yards of carry distance with the driver just by switching to this new model. That's pretty much all you need to know about this new ball. The other thing that we could add is that in the past, it's been pretty well known. There's been lots of different versions of Chrome Soft out there on tour. Well, what Callaway have told us is that Phil Mickelson, Francesco Molinari, and of course, Xander Schauffele, they're all playing with exactly the same model that is now the Chrome Soft X ball, which is on the shop floor, which you can actually buy. Okay, that's lots of information there about the Callaway Chrome Soft X. Let's go and see how Neil's getting on. Right, Neil, we've hit a lot of golf shots there.
Same, yeah.
Okay, just To be perfectly clear, people, we have hit all of these shots indoors using a net, using a Foresight GC2 launch monitor, and obviously all of these balls. And then we moved outside to be able to show you Neil hitting. Okay, Neil, just give us a bit of feedback about the Callaway-Chrome-Soft-X.
So, firstly, the thing that struck me, Simon, is if I was blindfolded or if these balls were blank, regardless of the dimple pattern, obviously, mm-hmm. I don't think I'd be able to have told much of a difference, really. So okay. In terms of feel, for me, I couldn't see. Couldn't okay. see a huge amount.
And just tell people a little bit about your background, because you're not a run-of-the-mill golf club pro either, are you?
No. I played at international level as a junior. I got down to +4, so as a decent amateur golfer. Still play quite a bit now as well. And I've only ever used the Pro V1, just the normal Pro V1. Okay. And I think after doing a little bit of ball testing, I think I'm putting myself on the back foot a little bit and using that ball.
Absolutely.
Just for, I mean, we'll touch up on it in a minute, but I feel like I'm losing a bit off the tee, mm-hmm. and I'm losing a little bit of spin control with a wedge when I'm okay. using that ball. So maybe the X would be a better option.
Okay, so let's just start off by looking at the driver then. Just talk us through what actually happened, because the Chrome-Soft-X has produced some pretty good numbers with the driver.
Definitely. Yep. Yeah, you can see that. I mean, if we were to highlight a full column, looking at that Chrome-Soft-X, complete thumbs up for all of it, really. Mm-hmm. Every box, it's produced the highest ball speed. I know it's only by 0.3 of a mile an hour, but it's still the highest. Mm-hmm. Launched at a decent angle, 10. These numbers here, anything around the 10 and the 2.5 mark, I'd be looking for be a fairway finder for me. I could perhaps try and get one launching a bit quicker with a little bit less spin, maybe. But remember, we've used my driver here, haven't we? So
yeah,
give it a fair result.
So what it really screams out to me is that we know that Titleist has quite firm compressions, mm. okay? So they're going to be fast. What we see from this really is that Chrome-Soft-X is very, very comparable.
Definitely.
It's 0.35 of a percent longer, which could be slightly different on a different day.
Yeah. I agree. But like we've just touched upon, I think that me using the V1 there, mm. I know it's only 2 mile an hour, but that I'm still giving away yardage, and I don't okay. at my level, I don't like doing that.
Okay, so just moving on to irons then. We've got some pretty impressive numbers that we feel because of launch angles, peak
yeah.
height.
Yeah. This is the thing what strikes me with the Chrome-Soft. It's launched a little bit quicker at mm-hmm. 17 than the other two. These are the numbers that I really like. Peak height of 35. Mm-hmm. Descend angle of 40. So it's going.
It's launching high.
Launching high.
It's flying high.
Flying high and
steep
coming.
Steep descent.
It's yep. gonna hold the greens a little bit better.
Okay.
Better for me, and especially with 6-4 in terms of spin rate. Mm-hmm. So that again, it's a performer, isn't it? It's done very well.
Okay. Moving on to the wedges then. You know, it's pretty tight again, isn't mm-hmm. it? You know, there's not a huge amount to choose between them, but pretty much exactly the same thing. Launched high. It's got a high peak height yeah. and then a steep descent onto the green.
Yeah, I mean, you'd normally find that, for me, a V1 and a V1X, if you were to say, oh, we're going to compare the Chrome-Soft to that today, before we do the test, I would probably think it's going to get nowhere near the Titleist, because everything seems to be compared to a Pro V1, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
But there you can see it has performed just as well.
Okay, so I guess what most people would really want to know is would you play that golf ball? Because you're a very, very high standard. Obviously, you've got Phil Mickelson, you've got Xander, you've got Molinari that plays it. You know, would you actually play that golf ball? And should other people play it themselves? Should they give it a try?
Yeah, definitely. 100%, yeah. I would. If you were to say to me, right, you've got to use these now for your, there's X amount, or you've got a year supply, whatever, go and give them a go. Looking at the data and what I've tested today, how they feel, how they perform, yeah, I dare say I would. And another thing that you might want to touch upon that might have an effect for the guys making their decision, firstly, I'd recommend that you go and try them yourself, but the price point is something that you've got to think about as well, because obviously the Chrome-Soft is considerably cheaper, isn't
it? Yeah, so the Chrome-Soft-X is 23% cheaper than what the Titleists are at a retail price. So for a lot of people, that will influence
over a year, that adds up, doesn't it? Do you know what I mean? If people buy, I don't know, maybe a couple of dozen a month or whatever, it's mm-hmm. a lot of money over a year's golf.
Okay, guys, that is the Chrome-Soft X against the Titleist Pro V1 and Pro V1X. It's a very, very tight call, but if price is a determining factor in your decision, then absolutely the Callaway is a pretty good performer.
Go and give it a try, guys, definitely.
Great, okay. Right, if you like the video, hit the like and subscribe button, and if you've got any comments or questions, leave them below, and we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.